right, guys, we made it on the plane. We were literally the last ones to arrive.
Good morning, Flight Deck, your captain speaking.
We're sitting in the airport all of a sudden. We heard Charles Rainer and party. Please come. We literally held up the entire plane. It's 5 a.m. right now. We're the last ones on the plane. We're headed to Toronto before we go to L.A. I'm a little bit tired right now, so we're not going to film the entire thing, but I will catch you guys in Toronto or L.A. Second flight now, guys. We're actually on our way to L.A. now. We stopped over in Toronto. We almost missed our flight again, but this time I'm actually completely edged, because check this out. I literally froze to death. And this one, this is not first class, but it's like halfway to first class. You got blankets, and the person beside me probably doesn't know that, so I'm going to steal theirs, and well, they can figure it out.
Welcome to Los Angeles. Local time is approximately 11 o'clock.
Been in LA, well, I say we because I'm with Charlie here now.
Charlie's already no king of LA, dog.
We've been in LA for a couple hours now, and well, we're starting it off right. We got Charlie's MacBook fix, and we're trying out these new little things. I have no idea what they're actually called.
Buffalo Blast.
Okay.
They're a blast of buffalo goodness and chicken.
It's pretty much like chicken deep fried in a tortilla sort of thing. And I've never been in the Cheesecake Factory before, so that's lit. And well, I'm also gonna try their drinks. We ordered like this peach Bellini sort of situation thing, and I'm a little worried that the waiter's gonna think that me and Charlie are sus, because we literally ordered the exact same everything and we ordered the grillier stuff. So we're gonna see how that situation plays out. But check this out. Tell me, Charlie, that does not look like the Eye of Sauron. Bro.
As soon as you point at it, I saw it, bro.
Like, that's the exact Family Guy clip just watching us eat right there.
Yeah.
Okay, this literally came a second ago. This is exactly what I was talking about. I'm H, though. Here we go. Cheers. That's amazing. Guys, I'm a little bit stressed out. I vlogged like a lot yesterday, and literally all the footage got deleted. But you know what? Today's another day, so we're skipping over yesterday, moving on to today. I'm video supply shopping with Charlie right now. We're doing the saltiest drink in the world, so we're literally buying anything that has anything to do with salt, like salted peanuts. We're gonna scrape the salt off the peanuts, put it in salted caramel. Well, I don't know how we're gonna get the salt off that, but we're gonna do it. But check this out right here. Look at this. We got just become an episode of Spill Your Guts or Fill Your Guts with the clam juice. I'm not exactly sure what clam juice even is, but you can see in the bottom of it, it's like actual nasty clam. Charlie, how much for you to drink this?
What is that?
This.
That's disgusting.
Chug the whole bottle. How much?
I'll never chug that. You got like, on my channel before I drink that.
No.
Yeah.
Seriously?
That's over.
You know what? I agree, that's completely over, but I'm feeling an episode of Spill Your Guts or Fill Your Guts. I'm out in LA, maybe I'll meet another YouTuber, and well, you know, LA is all about drama, and so the questions in that, I feel like it may start some drama. Who knows? Comment down below a YouTuber that you guys want me to hit up while I'm here, provided I release this video before I go back home, and maybe I'll reach out to them, tweet at them that I'm in LA, and maybe we'll reach out, do an episode of Spill Your Guts or Fill Your Guts. Maybe that's actually kind of bad, because, you know, first time I meet someone, I'm making them drink clam juice. That's over. Okay, I thought I was done showing weird things in the vlog with food. You guys think clam juice is bad? Well, it is bad, but check this out. I've literally only heard of this being in the States. We don't have this in Canada. This is the borderline grossest thing I've ever seen. Let me put this down and show this to you. It literally even says American right on it. Easy cheese American. Oh my. Let me know if any of you guys actually eat this. I'm considering buying it just to try it. I mean, it was on the shelf, and I feel like this thing should be refrigerated, and this is gross, and I'm gonna put it back. This should never be made. This is what I'm talking about. Check this out. It's like half sledgehammer, half axe sort of thing. To be honest, it's kind of heavy holding it. We're also, oh, I don't know if he's buying this, but we got a machete. I'm H. If I'm gonna spend any more time in LA, if I ever decide to come back to LA, I'm gonna need to buy some of these weapons myself. Because as you guys know, I have like an entire arsenal of weapons. I got everything from whips to crowbars to, well, myself, the pain train. And well, I'm gonna have to bring all that to LA, so that's over. I'm gonna have to just invest into buying some weapons while I'm here. I don't know if you guys have ever seen those cartoon movies. I've always legitimately been curious if this works.
What is that, rake?
You know what I'm gonna do?
Oh, yeah, it does work.
Does it?
It does work.
So you walk?
Yeah, it's quick.
Oh my god.
It's quick.
Bro, I might make a video out of this somehow, like stepping on 1,000 rakes or something.
Oh my god.
On some Mr. B shit. Just lay them everywhere like a minefield and just.
It's worse than Lego.
Yeah. This would wreck you in the face. All right. I'm gonna stop fooling around. I'm gonna put this back. Home Depot is just my kind of store. Look, it sells weird little things like this, like robotic arm sort of hand clampy things. So check this out from and do a little thing. Okay, test out my skills. It's called the clamp cam. I'm gonna get this bottle. Okay, I'm trash.
Charlie, you want that mop?
What?
You want that mop?
That mop? Why?
Yeah, no, I got it for you. It's okay.
Oh, yeah.
Right. High up, you know?
Whoa.
I got you, man.
Thank you for the mini mop, bro.
There you go. Do we actually need that?
What is this for?
I actually thought low-key we're actually going to keep it.
Nice, bro. Get that out of here.
Okay.
I would have put it back, personally. Let me just get good deed of the day for the vlog. Well, not for the vlog. I actually do this.
Oh, no. Now I actually need the thing to put back.
Okay, it's never going back up. I'm just gonna put it down on the shelf and walk away.
These washing machines need to chill. Like, oh my God.
I honestly feel like these things are gonna teleport me to the future. Like if Elon Musk designed a washing machine, this is how it would look. Look at this. I don't know why. I'm so aged right now. This is the type of thing Charlie would buy just to be overkill.
Look at this. It looks like it's about to come alive. Like E.T.'s gonna come out of there, or it's like a portal from Dragon Ball Z. Like it's gonna teleport me to the future, or like that's the next bad guy from the Avengers, or like Thanos is like looking, watching me. Okay,
a lot of things is what that could be. I'm just trying to show you that it looks cool.
Hi, my name is Just Dustin. Please subscribe. I can't show it to you guys, but over there inside that sink is
Well, it's the saltiest drink in the world, and I just may or may not have just swallowed it. I literally want to die. Going down, I gagged, and then Charlie offered me, he was like, I'll give you $100 if you can swallow it. So I swallowed it, and well, it was not worth $100 is what I'm trying to tell you. Guys, another thing I have to bring up. What the heck is this thing? It's like a garbage disposal sort of compost thing you guys here have here in the States, and it's stressing me out only because I like it so much and I want it in Canada. So Canadians, you have to get on this, okay? Start installing this in all homes. I've never seen this thing before in my entire life. I don't actually know what goes on in the drain. I'm picturing some sort of blender device sort of thing, which makes me kind of wonder, what if you put your hand down there? Can that like chop like chicken bones and stuff?
Yeah, it can chop anything.
Really?
Pretty much anything.
I feel like that's mad dangerous.
It is very dangerous. There's a warning, don't sink your arm in it.
Okay. Okay. Okay guys, so another day has passed, and well, I didn't vlog it because I didn't want to be the guy vlogging in that store. We just visited Rodeo. Honestly, it was really sick. I was kind of aged at some of the clothes. A lot of the clothes I wasn't because I had no idea what brands they are. You know, I'm not a huge hype beast. I need to learn these things. But yeah, so I found this Da Vinci shirt I liked, and I was like, oh, okay. I thought it was like 50% off at Barney's. That's what we're supposed to be having, like a big sale. Turns out that was like one of the only things that was regular price, and it was $750 US for a t-shirt. So I was really stressed out about it, and I didn't get it. Feeling kind of soft. He definitely thinks I'm soft. You think
you're
I'm soft.
Soft.
I am soft. Okay, you're all right. Soft. Well, we are moving on now. We're going to my man Bong Gizzle's favorite store, and a store that I actually really like. I've never actually been to. I just order all the stuff online. We're going to the OVO store. So hopefully there's two, maybe three things in there that I know I want for sure that are online, but they're sold out online, which means they're probably sold out here, but there's a chance. If I'm walking out with something here, it's gonna be a banger. Let's go check it out. All right, here we go. All right, guys, so the OVO store was completely over. They literally have nothing. If it's available online, it's available in there. That's it. Like, there was like 7 items in the entire store. Completely over. I'm stressed out about it. But guys, look at this. What is this right here? This is like a giant wavy kind of junkyard store. It literally looks like a junkyard, but it looks kind of like it was meant to be a junkyard, so. Probably a bajillion dollars.
Charlie's shown me a lot of crazy things in LA so far, but this tops all of it. We're on this I don't know where we are. We're somewhere in Beverly Hills where like literally, as you guys can see behind me, there's palm trees everywhere. There's tens of million dollar houses. Like even look,
that house right there, kind of dookie, right? It's probably worth like $10 million. That one right there, probably worth even more. This is where I want to live. I can't go home after this. Look at this view.
Best view in LA.
Best view in all of LA. Oh God, come on.
Come on, give me the times 100 zoom. Oh, the camera doesn't do it justice. Down there is the Hollywood sign. So yeah, the street is like, when you look to your left, you look to your, I said left and that was my right, but you get what I'm trying to say. When you look to your left, you look to your right, there's multi-million dollar mansion. Everything here is like immaculate. Like the grass, it looks fake. It's like everything is perfectly level. Everything's super clean cut. I love this place. I feel like the air here is better. And I'm looking at the Hollywood sign. It's a huge, there's no way. Like the houses over there are worth less than the houses one street over here. Cause this is perfect. How did you find this place?
Me and Gabe searched on Google.
Yeah.
4 days.
Bro, I don't know how this is legitimately not like one of the popular tourist places where they go to take a pic.
Online, it's not accurate where this is.
Okay.
And so like, me and Gabe literally had to go to like article, find places, drive back and forth between streets for days. Like literally one day we lost the sun because it was taking too long.
Jeez.
But then we came back the next day and finally found it. So it's, I'll give you guys the street. It's South Windsor and between the streets of 4th and 5th, I think, or maybe 5th and 6th. But if you look that up, you'll find it.
All right guys, so if you're trying to get some heat on the gram and you live in LA or you got enough money to fly to LA or if you got cousins or something in LA, now you got an excuse to come. That's where you guys get the best Instagram photos. Low key, I bet you anything, somebody is gonna do that.
No, I know they will.
If you do, tag us on Instagram. I'll make sure I like that pic.
All right, so another pretty much like hour and a half has passed. That means another meal is going down. We got some tender greens. I would consider this really healthy, but I did ask for medium. That's definitely well done. I'm stressed, but it is what it is. Ignore the mac and cheese, that's not healthy. All
right guys, now I've been to LA before, okay? I've seen this already, but I can't get used to it. There's something about seeing this that just makes me happy, makes me feel good. I'm talking about the Hollywood sign. Look at that thing. Oh shit, I lost everybody. Where's Charlie? Oh, okay, I see him. We're taking Wolfie to an actual dog park right now.
Dog park, here's the dogs. That. Is the Hollywood sign, guys. Check that out. I wonder how you actually get up there. Can you get up there?
No more.
Like, there's not even a road.
No. Like,
you can go above it where that electrical thing is. There's a road to go there. That's okay. Nice.
And then you can climb down. I feel like you get in trouble, though.
You cannot. See that helicopter?
Yes.
That's what's going to test you.
Really? Yeah. Saying they got a chopper gunner ready if you climb on the Hollywood sign.
Oh, Wolfie, go poo-poo. Yo, Sylvia, can I have the bag?
Oh, that's okay. All right. That's the end of this portion of the vlog. Rattlesnakes. Full out rattlesnake. It says literally, it's like, caution, rattlesnakes. And there's a schoolyard right there. Like, are you kidding me? That's insane.
I'm telling you, rattlesnakes are big out in LA. They're bougie.
And it also says no dogs, but there's a dog.
Guys, a lot of time has passed. Gabe, come back here. We just finished filming a video for Charlie's channel. Look at this.
Bro.
See that?
We stole a safe and yeah. We actually broke into it.
Okay, you weren't supposed to tell them that we stole it, but. All right, we got a safe from somewhere. We broke into it. Honestly, guys, this is gonna be one of the funniest videos I've ever filmed in my life. So it's gonna be coming out soon. So be prepared for that. It's an absolute banger. Why? Do these guys have the exact same scooters as you? Holy, I'm about to take that and go somewhere, except that I don't have anywhere to go. And well, I don't know these hills and I would probably die if I did that, so I'm just gonna leave it alone, figure out what I'm doing, and yeah. And to all you guys that think that we fake any of our videos, I can tell you with absolute certainty, one, that we just never do, but we legitimately, and we have proof on Charlie's channel, that we put his $30,000 chain inside that safe. It was, I mean, high risk, high reward, because there's a very, very high chance that we weren't gonna get that back. Okay, guys, so we are back at the house now. My camera, I'd love to show you, but it's sitting on a roll of paper towels right now, and it's my good camera. It feels really unsafe, but as you guys probably expected, I absolutely love LA. I've been to LA once, but I didn't really get to see it well because it was VidCon. We were just basically to and from VidCon the whole time. But now that I actually got to like feel LA a little bit, and I haven't even explored like 5% of it yet, I am starting to think about something I've been thinking of for a really long time, and that's honestly moving to LA. It'll be like a huge, I know. It'll be like a huge jump, and like, I mean, I'd have to do a lot of things, like get a visa and stuff like that and find a place. But now that like Charlie lives out here, I'm starting to make, you know, I'm starting to know a lot of other people here, feeling a little bit more like home here, even though it really doesn't feel like home yet. It's kind of a good thing.
It's gonna take a minute.
But it's kind of a good thing because it's different. You don't want it to feel too much like home.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
So I'm still thinking about it. I need your guys' help with this. We're gonna weigh the pros and the cons of living in LA versus living in Ottawa. So like, what do you think the pros are?
There's a few pros about LA. I'm in LA. Charlie's the weather is nice all the time.
That's not true.
The weather is nice all the time.
I've been here 3 days and it's been cloudy for 3 days.
Okay. And tomorrow? It's winter 79% of the time in Ottawa. So
all right,
nice.
That's fair.
Bro, if you can be in a hoodie,
yeah,
no boots, you're chilling.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, facts. All right, okay. Weather is obvious. I don't even know why I tried defending
this. There's a lot of cloud out here. Not much cloud back home.
That's kind of right.
There's room to grow, bro.
Yeah.
That's the thing.
Yeah.
There's room to grow. True. But pros about Ottawa.
Elbow.
You can blow shit up.
That's true. Where am I going to blow shit up here?
Yeah, there's not really too many open fields. Like, you cannot find open fields.
Everybody thinks I blow shit up all the time. I don't blow shit up all the time.
No, but some of the stuff, like, you're doing, bro, like, 100 layer walls, like, yeah, you're not getting the gym like that.
But I drop that every, like, once every 3 months.
Yeah. Well, it's kind of, you need a new one coming up.
Yeah.
So you can't be doing those here. True.
We're gonna film that though. You guys.
Literally, you only have me out here right now.
Yeah.
As of right now.
Yeah.
That's like, that's a very big con.
Yeah.
But honestly, if I had to choose one,
yeah,
I'd choose LA. I love LA.
Yeah.
I hate Ottawa. No. Everyone thinks I hate Ottawa. I don't hate Ottawa.
He really doesn't.
I just like.
But he really loves LA.
I wanted to do some next shit with my life. And bro, LA is not even my end goal. Oh? It's just like a little stepping stone. So I got my
where
visa.
Where else are you going? Mars?
I can like, live anywhere in the States. It's probably gonna be here or somewhere in the States. Yeah. But like,
if I move to LA, and you move from LA to somewhere else, I'm snuffing.
So
I'm
unfollowing
you off Instagram is what will happen.
Shit. Wait. I just got that follower back. That doesn't matter. No, but you should probably move quick, bro. Smash the like button, Dustonians. Let them know.
Comment down below whether you would like me to stay living in Ottawa or move to LA, or if you'd like me to just visit more. Just let me know your guys' thoughts. That's a good solution.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I got but I'll six still work on getting
I can do
visa.
6 months. I'll be like a snowbird. But
no, get the visa.
Yeah, I should get a visa.
Just like, bro, what if
get
you
a visa just
money,
to have it.
Invest in housing here.
Yeah, it's true. Well, guys, let me know in the comments down below what I should do. This is not even clickbait. This is legitimately, like, I don't know. I'm not saying that I'm gonna pack my bags and, oh, smash 50,000 likes and I'm moving to LA tonight. No, it's not like that. But I actually am thinking about it and I wanna know what you guys wanna see. If you guys like seeing the LA content, you guys wouldn't mind seeing me shift here, or you wanna keep seeing me make the Ottawa content, let me know. Or if you wanna see a mix of both and wanna just see me travel here a little bit more, let me know. I don't know why I'm holding a pencil like this is a calculated decision.
The mix is a vibe. You should move to the mix.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. All right, guys, let me know. Go down, smash that like button if you guys are loving these LA vlogs because they're not done yet. I got another one coming for you guys. I don't know when, but there's more coming. Anyways, guys, whether I'm in Ottawa or LA, you guys always know I always like to leave on a high note. That's a positive thing out here. I can sue we at any time of night. In Ottawa, I can't.
Wait.
Sue!
What?
Yeah, in Ottawa, they get mad at me for that.